Oh boy, oh boy. Oh shit. Oh shit. Hold up. Okay. Whew. Let me refresh real quick just to make sure everything's good. Alright, here we go. I didn't know walking backwards was possible. He didn't die. But cool, alright. It's 10 o'clock. Things should get started soon. Yo, I'm fucking hyped, dog. Wow. Okay. Oh, here we go. Alright. Okay. We got Isabel, K-Rool, Ice Climbers, okay. Damn, okay, this is the end of this bitch.
Hello, this is Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited, and this is the final Nintendo Direct before the launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
Okay.
So far, we've confirmed 72 fighters, 74 if you count Pokemon Trainers
3.
Our entire team has worked really hard. With this Nintendo Direct, we'll have revealed every fighter you can find in the game. Okay, let's do this.
Wait, let's do this. Hold up. Are we getting revealed already? Yo, we're getting revealed straight off the bat. Oh, it's Incineroar. It has. Are the leaks real? Oh, it's Ken. Is that Ken? It's Ken. That's Ken. Let's go, my boy Ken is in. Okay.
Bring it on.
Okay. Yo, I think the leaks are real. What?
Hold on. Nothing is
everything. Okay. Who's that? Is that Incineroar? Who's that?
That's right.
It has to be.
Yeah.
It's Incineroar, and so the leaks are real. Oh my God! It's Incineroar. Yo, what do you mean, Buzz? That's crazy. I didn't even think we were in a Pokemon
fight
run.
Fire with fire, huh?
Hailing from the Street Fighter series, Ryu's rival Ken joins as an Echo Fighter.
Okay.
In his original game, Ken could be considered Ryu's Echo Fighter. Back to Ken. Ken has been distinguished from Ryu over the years, but the Ken you'll see this time is based on Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo.
Okay.
Here's how he'll differ from Ryu. His heavy Shoryuken turns up the heat.
Okay.
The shape of his Hadouken is different too.
Okay.
And his Tatsumaki Senpūkeku strikes opponents multiple times.
Okay, that's cool.
Hell Wheel.
Hell Wheel?
focus attack.
His focus is weight, okay.
We've included lots of Ken's signature moves, such as his famous kicks, which change based on your command inputs.
Yo!
He's a bit faster than Ryu, and we've incorporated other tweaks from recent titles.
Just like Ryu,
he has two final smashes.
Of course he does.
First, the spinning uppercut, Shinryuken.
That's just clean.
We've made it look flashy, as it is in the Versus series.
That's just clean. That animation
got clean. Execute
a
final smash near an opponent, and you'll instead perform a Shippu Jinraigeki.
That's just clean as well. Holy fuck. They really mastered these animations. Incineroar runs about. Okay, so
now for our last new challenger, Incineroar. It may be a Pokemon, but it mainly uses pro wrestling moves, and as such, its throws are a bit more powerful.
Okay,
like a true pro wrestler, when one of its attacks is successful, it'll pose for the audience. Luckily, you can cancel out of these poses at any time, so they won't open you up to additional enemy attacks.
You can mind game your opponents.
Its neutral special is called Darkest Lariat.
It was
Incineroar's signature move in the Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon games.
Yep.
Perhaps it's something of a red cyclone.
Yeah.
Its up special is Cross Chop.
Cross Chop? That's Cross Chop?
You'll leap up and come rocketing back down.
A Cross Chop is a fighting.
This attack can be very effective, but if you mess up, it's
easy
to self-destruct, so be careful. For its side special, Incineroar makes opponents run the ropes after a dashing grab.
So he has
when they bounce back
grab.
Your way, press the button at just the right moment. If you're too early, you'll do a
back body drop.
Wait too long and you'll fail. Nail the timing and you'll pull off a powerful lariat.
Damn! My boy Lucas got body! Damn,
its
Lucas.
Down special is Revenge.
Revenge. Okay, it's a counter. Nice. So he's a counter.
When damaged, Incineroar's Burning Passion comes to the surface, powering up its next attack.
Whoa, what
that's
the?
That's Incineroar's
counterattack. Damn! My boy got body!
And its final smash?
Max
Malicious
Moonsault.
It's even faster and fiercer than the Z move it's based on.
What? The roster has been revealed. That's it.
We finally revealed all of the fighters you'll find in the game.
No, Sakurai?
This is the initial fighter select screen. There aren't very many at first, but it is the same amount as the original Nintendo 64 game. And once you've unlocked them all, it'll look like this.
Holy shit!
It may seem hard to guess where each one's located, but they're sorted by number in the order they joined the series.
Bro.
I hope you'll enjoy battling with all 74 fighters on the roster.
Counting Pokemon trainers one. Okay, he noted. Okay, amiibos. Okay, hey, hold up. Alright, so two amiibos. Okay, that's kind of clean. I'm not gonna buy amiibos probably. Unless it's like for a character that I want. Okay, really emo as well. Okay, that's kind of clean. They got a wolf here. Damn. I might have to cop that wheel, the Wolf remote. It looks kind of clean. And it's available on the release date.
You may recall that we're creating amiibo in parallel with the game. Here's a look at the new amiibo figures.
Damn, okay, Kenzo looks kind of clean. Gaming icons.
We determined the collectible trophies wouldn't be a great fit for this game.
Okay.
Honestly,
so
they were really difficult to develop too.
Okay.
That said, the Super Smash Bros. Series is one massive crossover at heart, and we want to create something more. A way to enjoy characters other than fighters.
Wait, what?
From a variety of video game worlds.
Huh?
Here's what we came up with.
Speedy.
They're called Spirits.
Spirits? So this is the mode!
And I don't mean the spooky kind. To put it simply, these spirit characters will lend a helping hand to your fighters, powering them up in battle.
So TV Robo's disconfirmed. Wait, what? Imagination meets reality.
In the Super Smash Bros. Series, the characters are toys in the real world, but they are fighters in the world of the imagination.
Okay.
Returning to the real world is an ongoing theme.
Okay.
In the imagination, you can battle impossible combinations of characters. In this mysterious world, the unspeakable happens. Many beloved characters lose their physical forms. All of them, except the fighters, are turned into spirits, unable to return to the real world.
Bro.
This is a spirit. Fighters can join forces with spirits to enhance their powers.
What?
There's a massive amount of wildly different spirits.
Bro, this is crazy.
There are several classes of spirits. Standard spirits are dubbed novices. Stronger ones have the title advanced.
Okay, silver.
Especially strong ones are called aces. And some are in a league of their own.
Okay.
Legend.
No, who's that man? Listen to me, what kind of toy?
One primary spirit can be assigned at a time.
Huh.
A primary spirit's power will be added to the fighter who has it equipped. In some cases, these augmented fighters become extremely powerful.
Damn! Oh boy, at 10K!
If a primary spirit has enough available slots, you can assign them support spirits.
Spiritception. Is that Cappy and Volpix?
While primary spirits enhance fighter stats, support spirits lend them additional skills.
Okay. Slippy, okay.
Once the primary spirit and support spirits are set, your fighter's all powered up. The main way to acquire spirits is to win spirit battles. You'll find a variety of spirits lined up on the spirit board.
Okay.
Choose the one you want to battle for. When you do, you'll face off against a fighter whose abilities and personality are kinda sorta similar to the opposing spirit.
Okay.
In the case of the Lakitu and Spiny spirit, you'll battle against Iggy Koopa and a group of small red Bowsers.
Okay.
Iggy's riding high in his Koopa Clown car, of course.
That's kinda
Here are some examples of other battles you can expect.
Yo, okay, so it's like that's actually kind of cool. I see what they're doing here. I like the console. I don't know who the fuck that is.
Come on.
Owain?
Come on.
Who?
Not bad. Come on. Come on.
Taunt at every opportunity. Okay. Conditions of enemies who are on move slower. Time's everywhere. Okay. You're him. Huh. They're really showing us a lot. That's crazy. I didn't think they'd give this much gameplay experience. I thought it was like gonna give us like the just the gist of it. Darky Dog is protected by a giant. I don't get the spirit thing. It's kinda complicated. Okay, it's kinda complicated at this point. I'll try to explain it though. I could be a director or whatever. Okay.
Hit the puppet fighter to acquire the spirit within.
Huh. Okay.
Even if you accidentally hit the shield, the damage will carry over, so you'll have an advantage the next time you encounter that spirit.
To your character that does like challenges in like the actual mode.
Primary spirits have strength based on their type.
Okay.
Attack is strong against grab. Grab is strong against shield, and shield is strong against attack.
Okay.
It's important to pick a spirit that has an advantage over your opponent.
Okay.
When you encounter traps like poison floors and slumber floors, be sure to prep yourself with an appropriate support spirit. Battle conditions offer hints before battle, so make sure to read them and form the right strategy. With spirits on your side, there are all kinds of things you can do. When you fight with a primary spirit equipped, it'll level up after battle.
Okay.
Or you can feed it snacks.
Snacks. Okay. Now levels up.
Some spirits even have an enhanced form you can only unlock by leveling them up.
Feels bad,
you can also send spirits back to the real world.
Damn.
While you do have to say goodbye to that particular spirit, its core will stay.
So unlucky.
And by combining these cores, you can summon a new spirit.
Okay. That kind of makes sense.
You can also train spirits at dojos in the gym.
Damn.
Or send them off in search of treasure, which they'll bring back to you.
Okay.
These seem like unlikely teams of characters, but each team could be somebody's dream come true. Training and exploring continues to yield results, even while playing other modes, or after turning off the game. So if you send out your spirits, just let them do their thing.
Okay, that's kind of clean. So these are like, this is nice.
Certain spirits are known as masters. You can beat them to unlock facilities. Spirits can also be used to power up amiibo figure players. You must bid them farewell, but you can repeat the process multiple times.
Okay.
It's one great big collection of characters from many different series, but just how many would you guess there are?
A lot. Final smash meter, okay, more information.
Whenever you fight against the spirit, the final smash meter is enabled.
Okay.
Some spirits even help you
fill
up your page at a faster rate.
This is new. Oh, damn! They're getting that bitch. Damn!
Another way to put it, the spirit system lets you simulate battles between characters from more series than ever before. You can enjoy many unbelievable combinations and situations. The power of enemy and ally spirit teams is displayed here. Of course, stronger spirit teams make it easier to defeat weaker spirits. The more your power overshadows theirs, the less you'll be rewarded. It pays to have a fair fight.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Okay. So that way you don't get like,
while assembling a team, press the Y button for a recommendation that has a type advantage against the opposing spirit team.
Okay.
The game will recommend support spirits who can help out with certain conditions.
Okay.
Keep that in mind. You can also fight against other players who are using spirits.
Okay.
Given the way spirit types interact in battle,
what?
Think carefully when building your team. Or balance your strengths in a 2-on-2 battle.
Local wireless and all. Okay, here we go.
The game lets you battle together with friends via local wireless, or take the fight to the world with online play.
Okay, please tell me online is actually good.
To connect two Nintendo Switch consoles, press the ZR button to pull up the dashboard and select local wireless.
Okay. Online, here we go, okay. Woo, please.
There's no longer a need to separate the online modes into for fun and for glory.
I don't.
Instead, matchmaking is based on three factors.
Okay, hold on. Please rank. Preferred rules, okay.
For online battles, you can set your preferred rules.
Okay, I mean,
these rules
that's cool.
Be pre-registered so you can quickly select your favorite playstyle.
Okay.
Before battle, one player's preferred rules will be chosen at random, and all players will fight using those rules.
Okay.
You can also choose not to set any preferred rules and let the others decide instead.
Okay, that's cool.
If possible, the matchmaking system
Damn.
Will find players with similar preferences and link them up for a battle.
Yeah.
Global Smash Power is being factored into matchmaking, but it's still used as an online leaderboard as well.
Please get revamped or something.
A high GSV score, such as 100,000, means you've got more points than 99,999 other players.
Okay.
Your GSP will change as the total population of players increases or you're overtaken.
Okay.
If you're yearning for a challenge, try increasing your global smash power so that you'll naturally end up with some more serious opponents.
Like a ranked system.
By the way, you can set a GSB score for each fighter. Fighters you haven't used yet will be assigned a placeholder GSP based on the highest score you've set with one of the other fighters. If you repeatedly self-destruct on purpose, you could face a penalty, like being disconnected.
Damn.
So please don't do that.
I got the boot. The distance between players matter. Okay,
any multiplayer game, a stable connection is very important.
That's true.
For this reason, the matchmaking system will prioritize shorter distances between players.
Thank you!
So even if you set your preferred rules, please understand
you.
That we can't promise you'll always be matched accordingly.
That's fine. I just want better.
As such, we'd appreciate it if you could make your connection as stable as possible. A wired LAN cable is recommended.
Yeah, of course.
We've prepared a variety of other features for local wireless and online battles.
Elite battles.
Once your global smash power is high enough, you can enter elite battles.
Wait, what does that mean?
When you reach this level, feel free to pat yourself on the back. You're good, period.
Oh,
after the game releases, we may adjust the game balance.
So
and the team
right.
will definitely pay attention to the results of these elite
like
battles.
Sort of. Okay.
Everyone who plays online needs their own smash tag.
Smash tag, okay.
If you beat a fellow player, you'll receive their smash tag.
Oh!
But it's not like you'll lose your smash tag even if you lose a battle. You
Damn.
Simply gain more tags as you win. Try to collect
okay.
lots of smash tags.
Sounds like, okay.
You can select short messages and send them before and after battles using the directional buttons.
Okay, let's smash it.
Freely choose from a wide selection of varied preset messages.
That's actually like that. Yeah,
after you've chosen a fighter, you can enjoy other modes while you wait for the battle to begin.
Okay, that's clean. Nice.
Not every mode will be available while matchmaking runs in the background,
training?
But you
okay,
can
training,
leave
training.
And enter some game modes.
That's dope. That's actually so dope.
Spectator mode returns
okay.
once again,
what's
so you can watch
like?
Other players' battles.
Please be live.
Maybe
live
you can pick up some good tips that way.
No. Form a two-player team. Wait, what?
Form a two-player team and play together online with a single Nintendo Switch system.
Okay.
You'll be paired up against two-player teams with the same setup.
Okay, that's dope. Battle arena? Okay.
When you want to play online, you can create a special type of room to fight
All
other
skill
players.
Levels.
If you set the rules for one of these battle arenas, you can fight against your friends. Here,
huh.
there are spots where you can join the battle, wait in line, or even
insane.
Spectate.
This is so much.
It all depends where you place your token. When you're in a battle arena, this should come in handy.
Our phone?
With the Nintendo Switch Online app, you can voice
oh, yeah,
chat with others in battle arenas. It may become an essential tool for some players. We are also developing a free service for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate,
what?
And we're naming it Smash World.
Smash World.
Instead of focusing on stats like win-loss records, we're allowing players to post gameplay videos, watch them, and more.
Okay.
Once the service starts, we'll offer regular updates so you can post to your heart's content.
Okay. Huh. Alright.
Next, I'd like to change topics and talk a little about the assist trophies that will support your fighters in battle. Do you know which characters come from which games?
No! My heart! What's this?
Nani?
Nani? Minutes in. Okay, this is another. Okay!
Blast kick!
Yelling there.
That was nothing.
What's this? I have no idea what this is. Yo, what's up,
everybody?
Huh. I have no idea who that is.
The total number of assist trophies is now 59.
Okay, so
actually, they outnumber the Pokemon this time. Assist trophies who can be KO'd can also be defeated by the fighter who summoned them just before they're KO'd. That way, you won't lose a point to the other player.
Other features? Okay.
Now, I'd like to cover a variety of other features.
I know there is, dog! Help. Oh, damn, that's
if you want to review the controls or game modes, press the ZR button to open the dashboard and look in here.
Dude, this is a clean
there
mode,
are
dude.
All kinds of helpful guides to check out.
Okay. I know a lot of y'all gonna be needing this. Sentry Smash.
Sentry Smash may look familiar to veterans. It feels great to keep smashing enemies off the screen, doesn't it? You can play on many different stages, and you can choose the music too.
Okay.
In previous games, you had to unlock every fighter before playing All-Star mode. But now, you can play it right out of the box.
Okay, that's kind of clean.
The currently available fighters will appear endlessly.
Okay.
You can save the replay data of your battles.
Bro, I'm at round 37.
And now,
nice.
You can create videos with it.
Okay, I don't know where the...
There's also a menu where you can read those quick tips and tricks you see during loading screens.
Okay.
When viewing them, you can sort by category or fighter.
Okay.
Complete challenges to earn rewards. This time, each page is sorted by category, and the layout looks more like a comic book.
Okay.
Press the button to check out each picture. Enjoy!
Records, okay.
The records menu tracks your battle history.
Yeah.
There are 5 different options. You can view battle data separately for offline and online play.
Okay.
Trade in smash tags to score some in-game gold.
This fucking direct is crazy, man. We've already had so much shop, hold on.
Gold can be exchanged for music tracks, spirits, and items for spirits mode.
Okay.
If you're collecting music, I recommend visiting the shop to find the ones you want, instead of just relying on challenges.
Options, okay. What's in the options?
You can enter the options menu by pressing the ZR button to open the dashboard.
Okay. Language support.
This one game supports 11 languages.
Okay, that's actually kind
of
clean.
I know this is very important to some of you.
Yeah, that's a lot of work.
For example, the voices of Pokemon are different in several languages.
Really? They put so much work into this game, holy shit!
The fighter names are also specific to each language.
Fuck, man! These guys are insane!
Aldeano.
Telefona. Abitante. Dorfbewohner.
These options were highly requested and well worth the effort.
Bro!
Maljumin.
What?
TV mode and handheld mode have separate settings for brightness and sound. They'll change automatically when you dock and undock, so be sure to set both.
Okay.
We've implemented a radar that displays the locations of all fighters. You can change its settings, including size.
Okay.
While it's limited to wireless and online play, you can make your teammates semi-transparent so you don't get distracted.
Okay, that's kind of cool. It's gonna be useful in twos. Four doubles. Custom battle. Okay, hold on, what is this?
If you're fighting against a friend on the same system, you can adjust the strength of your fighters. Sometimes a player is just too good, and you want to take measures to ensure it's a fair fight.
Okay.
If that's the case, try using this feature.
Okay,
When custom balance is adjusted, a symbol will be displayed. Of course, this feature is not available during wireless and online battles.
If it was, that'd be kind of crazy. Mii fighters. All right, what's up with Mii
You
fighters?
Can customize your Mii fighters and change their outfits.
Is Xeno still an outfit?
In addition to the voice options, there are a variety of outfits to choose from.
Okay. That gonna be strictly.
Mii Fighter.
Speaking of Mii Fighters, let me introduce you to some new outfits we added in.
Oh god, please no, hold up. Don't get Mii Fighter, please. Okay. Yo, I'll skip one of the characters that I like, might get them confirmed for a Mii Fighter outfit. Looking good, thanks, Doug. Splatoon 2. Jesus Christ, why this not okay? Sakura didn't think that Arms was good enough to be a fighter, I guess. Because he could have made them. Which makes me think that Rex and Pyro might be a thing, chat. Hold on. Oh, Rain right there. Damn. Is there just so much in this game? Yeah. Rex and Pyro might be a thing. Spring or Arms and Xenoblade came out at the same time. It might be a thing. They might be a thing. And so, yo, I'm fucking crying. On the street, that's a fact.
Anyway, there's something I should point out. As I said, we've revealed all of the fighters you can
find. DLC! DLC! Here we go! Let's go! Here we go!
Roster of fighters, this is the Super Smash Brothers series. Which means we're leaving the opportunity open to add in more fighters to paid DLC.
Please, Sakurai! Please.
Since we already included every fighter from the past games, that means there are no more fighters to include unless we develop new fighters from scratch. And we're not talking about Echo fighters.
Okay!
We'll be developing and selling sets that will include one fighter, one stage, and multiple music tracks.
Okay!
The price for each set is expected to be $5.99.
For character, stage, and music? Bro.
At the same time, we will offer the Fighters Pass.
Hold up, pause.
That's five fighters, five stages, and all of their music tracks.
Through 2020!
When creating something like the Fighters Pass, ideally, we should reveal what's included before it becomes available for purchase.
Wait,
however, please allow us to offer this pass before we're ready to reveal its contents.
Okay, that's fine.
I hope only those who are confident in its value will purchase it. Again, the price is $24.99 for all five sets. Now that we've finally confirmed the development of this DLC, please know that we'll be working really hard on it. I wonder if I'll ever get to take a break.
I don't know, man.
By the way, here's one purchase bonus you'll get with the Fighter's Pass.
Hold up. No!
It's a Mii Sword Fighter outfit based on Rex from Xenoblade Chronicles 2.
No!
We decided which fighters to include when we started planning, so we couldn't add characters from titles like Xenoblade Chronicles 2, which was announced after planning had started. I hope this outfit will help you feel like you're playing as Rex. We're also including some music from the Xenoblade Chronicles series. Give it a listen at Gaara Plain sometime. Other Xenoblade Chronicles characters will also appear as spirits. We've yet to create any of the paid DLC, and we haven't locked down any release dates, but we'll start working on them as soon as we're finished with the main game. It may take around a year or so to finish releasing all the DLC. But, on a separate note, we're currently developing something. Something you'll get for free as a limited time offer if you buy the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game now. It isn't finished yet, but I want to give you a special sneak peek. That's right. Piranha Plant will take root in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and not as an assist trophy, but as an actual fighter. It can spit poison, fire off spiky balls, and perform long-range attacks. This tricky character is full of surprises. Its final smash is PD Piranha. If you get caught in the cage, well, let's just say it won't end well for you. Piranha Plant is scheduled for completion after the launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. We've gotten a little head start on it, but it probably won't be ready until a couple of months after launch. Please stay tuned. Remember, Piranha Plant is a free, limited-time offer. For the physical version of the game, you only need to go through the My Nintendo Gold Point registration process to receive it. I hope you'll consider pre-ordering. We're also creating an amiibo. It has a nice curved form to it. Later today, you'll be able to pre-purchase the game after finishing this Nintendo Direct. I hope you'll go to Nintendo eShop or Nintendo.com before you forget. I have an announcement for everyone watching this in North America. On our official site, you can find information for a variety of upcoming hands-on events. Participants will have a chance to try out all 74 fighters, so please check out the website to find out where we'll show up next, and more. That's it for the last Nintendo Direct for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate before the game launches. But before we go, I should mention that the adventure mode in this game is nothing like what we came up with for the Subspace Emissary. That said, what exactly caused all these characters to lose their bodies and transform into spirits? I'll show you how it all begins and leave the rest to your imagination. Okay then, please look forward to the game's release.
Don't let a single one get away!
We'll each need to take down about 10.
Stow your fear. It's now or never.
We'll win this. I know we will.
to aspire.